Very good morning, all of you. We are continuing exercise 7P. Today we are starting by question number 27. Question is, the length of a rectangular field is twice its breadth. If the perimeter of the field is 150 meters, find its length and breadth. Very easy question. Here, the relation between length and breadth is given. Length is twice its breadth. So we can take the breadth of the rectangular as x. Let x be the breadth and length be 2x. If the perimeter of the field is 150, what is perimeter? Perimeter is equal to 2 into l plus b. Is it? L is length, b is breadth. And we can substitute our values in this equation. That is 2 into l is 2x, b is x. That perimeter is equal to 150. So this is the equation we are getting from the question. 150 is equal to 2 into 2x plus x. We can expand this. 2 into 2x, 4x plus 2 into x, 2x only. So 4x plus 2x become 6x. That is 6x is equal to 150. Therefore, x is equal to 150 divided by 6, and this is equal to 25. If x is equal to 25, x is the breadth. That 25 meter, or breadth is equal to 25 meters, and length is equal to 2 into x, that is 2 into 25 is equal to 50 meters. Number 29, two complementary angles differ by 8 degrees. Find the angles. What do you mean by complementary angles? If the sum of two angles is equal to 90 degrees, then that two angles are known as complementary angles, is it? So it is the difference between that complementary angles is 8 degrees. So we can take the complementary angles like this. Let the complementary angles be x degree, then the second will be 90 minus x degree, because their sum will be is equal to 90. So the second one we are taking as 90 minus x. And what is given in the question? Their difference is 8 degree. That is x degree minus 90 minus x degree is equal to 8 degree. Then x degree minus 90 minus minus become plus. Plus x degree is equal to 8. X plus x become 2x. 2x minus 2x degree minus 90 is equal to 8 degree. That is 2x degree is equal to 8 plus 90. 90 plus 8 become 98. Or x degree is equal to 98 divided by 2. And this is equal to 49. That if x is equal to 49, what is 90 minus x? Then 90 minus x degree is equal to 90 minus 49, which is equal to 41. Therefore, the complementary angles are 49 and 41. Question number 32. A man travelled 3 by 5 of his journey by rail, 1 by 4 by a taxi, 1 by 8 by a bus, and the remaining is 2 km on foot. What is the length of his total journey? Listen, we don't know what is the length of his total journey. So that journey, total length, we can take as x. If the total journey is x, he travelled 3 by 5 of the total journey by rail. That is 3 by 5 x. Then 1 by 4 of the total journey by a taxi. That is x by 4. Is it? Then 1 by 8 by a bus, that is x by 8, and the remaining 2 km on foot, that is 2 km he travelled on foot. So when we are adding all these things, we will get the total journey, is it? So we can add them. Here the denominators are 5, 4 and 8. So here the LCM of these denominators is 40. So we can do like this. We are going to multiply. we can multiply each one by 40, then all the denominators will become cancelled. Then 40 into 3 by 5x plus 40 into x by 4 plus 40 into x by 8 plus 40 into 2 is equal to 40 into x. Now 40 and 5 we can cancel. 8 into 3x plus 40 and 4 we can cancel. 10, 10x plus 40 and 8 we can cancel. 5x plus 40 into 2, 80 is equal to 40x. Now we can add all the terms of x. Here 8 threes are 24. 24 plus 10, 34. 34 plus 5, 39. 39x plus 80 is equal to 40x. That is 80 is equal to 40x minus 39x, which is equal to x. That is x is equal to 80, which implies total journey is equal to 80 kilometer. Question number 33. A laborer is engaged for 20 days on the condition that he will receive rupees 120 for each day he works, and he will be fined rupees 10 for each day he is absent. If he receives 1880 rupees in all, for how many days did he remain absent? You listen the question once again. A laborer is ready to work for 20 days. Okay, the condition is like this. If he is present for the day, he will receive 120 rupees. If he is absent for any one day, he has to find rupees 10. And total amount he received is 1880 rupees. So we should find how many days. So we have to find how many days he was absent for the job. We can take like this. Let the number of days absent be x. Then the number of days present be 20 minus x, because here 20 is the total number of days. So from the question, if he is present for any one day, number of days present is 20 minus x. So for one day he is receiving rupees 120. So 20 minus x into 120. If he is present, he will get this much of amount. If he is absent, number of days absent is x. How much he has to pay? 10 rupees is his fine. So x into 10, that will subtract. But he total he received 1880 rupees. So this is the equation we are getting from the question. So from here we will find what is the value of x. Here 20 into 120 become 2400, is it? Minus 120x minus 10x is equal to 1880. Now 2400, here minus 120 minus 10 become minus 130x is equal to 1880. Now we can take this term of x to this side, and this constant time we can take to this LHS. So 2400 minus 1880 is equal to 130x, and here this number will be 520. Okay, 520 is equal to 130x, which implies x is equal to 520 by 130, or 52 divided by 13. 52 divided by 13 is 4. Therefore number of days absent, number of days absent is equal to 4 days. Okay.